Hello, Meg here from PMTV UK. I hope you are all well. It's that time of year again. We have reached the point of the year where we're going to take a look back at some of our favourite products from 2023. This particular video, I'm going to take a look at my favourite acoustic guitars from the year that don't break the bank, but still sound and play great. Quick disclaimer, some of the guitars in this video aren't necessarily new releases this year, but I'm including them in this list because they still remain some of my favourites, even as more guitars come out over the years. Before I dive into the video and get into which five I've chosen, make sure you hit that subscribe button and click the little notification bell if you want to get notified every time we have a new video on the channel. So the first guitar in my hands I wanted to start with is the Ferndale D3. This one I definitely did include in last year's video, but it's worth another mention in this year's video just because this is still one of my favourite affordable, beginner-friendly, but good-sounding Dreadnought acoustics. This is the non-electric version, so there's no pickup in. You can get a version with a preamp in if you need it. But in terms of a super playable, really comfortable, but still good-sounding Dreadnought, this is absolutely one of my favourites. The build quality is fantastic and the spruce and mahogany wood pairing gives this such a nice balanced sound. It's often hard to find a beginner's friendly or budget friendly acoustic guitar that hasn't lost some of the quality and makes it a bit harder to play on. Especially if you are a beginner, you want everything you can to help you keep playing, get your fingers trained up and to keep you motivated to pick up the guitar every day. This is perfect guitar for that, hence why I wanted to include it on this list. In terms of the specs of this particular guitar and why I think it's such a good build quality and still sounds good even for the price point, this has a spruce top with a layered sapele back and sides, and it's a solid spruce top too, so you've got extra resonance and extra tone that is going to come out the more that this is played in. That sapele is a lot like mahogany too, so it responds the same sort of way mahogany would to a spruce top guitar, with adding a lot of mellow warmth to pair with that brightness from the spruce. The neck is not too overly rounded, it's really comfortable to play and it's definitely built with beginners in mind, but if you are a more seasoned player then this is going to be a comfortable acoustic guitar to play. Dreadnoughts aren't for everyone, especially if you are a beginner, they can seem quite bulky, but the general build of this guitar is definitely built with that in mind, so I feel like this is still a very comfortable guitar to play. Not just that though, the most important part of course, it has a great tone and something that has not been compromised, even though the price point is on the lower end with this particular guitar. And as I said, if you were after an electric version, one that you can plug in at gigs, there is also the D3E. I will pop all the product links in the description box for the guitars mentioned in this video if you wanted to check any of them out or if you wanted to find out what they were so you could go into store and try them. But this is a simple Dreadnought, really effective design. It's a nod to some of the more iconic higher end acoustic guitars, something like a Martin D28. It's got that look about it, but the most important things, of course, it plays well and it sounds great. Thank you. Guitar number two on my list is another Ferndale. This one is a new release from this year, however though, this is the Ferndale Plus model. I wanted to include this in the list for a couple reasons. I love the sound and the tone of this guitar. I think it's got a lot more earthiness to it than some of the other brighter Ferndales in the range, but of course it's also completely unique in design and I love the finish on it. Being a rootsy player in general, so folk and blues, in the sort of crowds and musicians that I'm around, a lot of them tend to play quite earthy looking guitars and earthy sounding guitars, so this fits right into that box for me and hence I wanted to include it. Across the range of Ferndales there is quite a variety of different body shapes. There's parlor guitars, travel guitars, dreadnoughts, grand auditoriums, but most of them have a gloss finish and they are sort of spruce appealy back and sides or a mahogany top. This one I think stands out as a unique model in the range of Ferndales. Its tone is completely different to all the others that I've played. The neck feels completely different, nice and comfortable, but with a satin finish instead of a gloss finish, I find it even more comfortable to play for the sort of finger picking styles that I'd want to play on a guitar like this. And this whiskey barrel-esque finish is one of my favourites, I think, from the whole Ferndale range. Each one I've seen is slightly different, so the finish can be completely unique from each guitar. The body shape itself is nice and comfortable, and with the cutaway up here, you've got easy access to the frets if you are playing a lot of finger picking all the way up and down the neck. Plus, the built-in pickup system is really thorough. It's got EQ, volume, and there's even a presence option on there as well. So you've got a lot of control over the sound through the line in if you are using this as a gigging guitar too. This is priced up slightly than some of the other Ferndales in the range. So if you are looking for a guitar to get you started with gigging or something to upgrade from your first guitar, then this would be a great option. Tonally, I think it sounds quite similar to some of the all mahogany guitars I've played before, but it does have its own unique characteristic and hence why I wanted to include this one in the list. This has only been out for a few months as well, so you may not have had a chance to play this guitar, and I would definitely recommend having a go on this and comparing it to some of the spruce top, mahogany back and sides, gloss finish guitars that are in the Ferndale range. Your ears will be the best judge of which one you prefer, but I know for myself this guitar is right up my street and definitely lends itself nicely to those sort of folk, blues and roots genres that I tend to want to play on an acoustic guitar. It's not just limited to this though. I've played some strumming, I'm going to play some finger picking, and you'll be able to hear how versatile this is tonally. It would fit a whole range of different genres. It's not just going to be good for those folk and blues sounds, but that is why I like this guitar so much. APX600 in satin finish. Most of you, I'm sure if you are a fan of acoustic guitars, will definitely be aware of the Yamaha APX. This model itself is not new. In fact, it's gone through so many evolutions over the last 15 years. I've played so many different versions of it, different tone woods, and it's slightly changed and tweaked, even being slightly shortened in scale length over the last couple of years to make it even more comfortable for people to play. Things that the APX is famous for, of course, is having that thin line body and a neck that plays very similarly to an electric guitar. This has always been a popular choice for players who play a lot of lead guitar or are a natural electric guitarist that need an acoustic in their collection. But this is the first time in many, many years that I've seen a satin finish APX join the range. Back in the day, they did used to have some, but they have been gloss finished for so long, and there's something I absolutely love about how this looks and feels. Whilst the gloss finish is of course amazing for not just visual reasons, but it does help add a layer of protection against humidity. With this satin finish is my favourite sort of guitar neck. A really smooth satin neck with a comfortable neck profile is so enjoyable to play. Plus, the APXs are known for this anyway, so this just creates a ridiculously easy guitar to play. Great sounding pickup built in, so a perfect guitar for gigging. I think it looks really neat, and I am pleased that they've joined this to the family. A matte finish on an APX is a really classy look, especially with that mahogany on the back and sides. I'm a massive fan, and I think APXs will stand the test of time. There's a reason they've been so popular and have been around for so long. They really are a comfortable guitar to play. Not only that, the quality of the pickups on these guitars mean that when you do plug them in, even despite the smaller body, there is so much depth to the sound that you do not compromise any of the tone whilst you're playing live with a guitar like this. A thin line body obviously is not going to give you the same bassiness as the jumbo guitar that I've played just before that, but when you are choosing a guitar like this, I think that is something you're aware of, and if comfortability and easy playability is something that you are looking for, then the APXs are always going to be great for that. And the final guitar on my list for this year is the Taylor Academy 10E in Walnut. The Taylor Academies have been around for about 5 or so years now, but this year they introduced a walnut top and back and sides version, and I absolutely love it. Earlier on in the year, I did a review for this guitar. I played through some different styles on both the dreadnought shape and the slightly curvier, more grand auditorium style shape. and it has such a different tonal characteristic to the spruce version. I think it's a fantastic addition to the lineup. If you are a fan of something a bit more mellow or a bit closer to a tone wood like mahogany, but not quite as earthy as a mahogany, then walnut is a fantastic wood for that when it comes to acoustics. If you compare this to the spruce top, which is naturally quite bright, this really has a slightly softer sound and a bit more balance in the mid-range, which really comes out when you do play a finger-picking sort of pattern like I played just now. I also think that walnut is one of the most visually amazing tone woods to look at on an acoustic. You get such unique grains, and every single one of these looks slightly different. A bit similar to how koa reacts on acoustics, where you never quite know what it's going to look like when you get it out. This one has this really lovely stripe down the middle, but they're all totally unique, and the walnut grain is absolutely gorgeous. It's a great tone wood to use for acoustics, but something that isn't used too often by brands. So I was a big fan of this when it first came out and thoroughly enjoyed that guitar review this year. It's a little bit more pricey than some of the other guitars I've mentioned in this video, but I wanted to include it because if you are looking for something where you wanted to spend a little bit more, but it's still aimed at an easy playable beginner's guitar, then the Taylor Academies are always going to be a great shout for that. Their necks are not too overly rounded, really comfortable to play. The body shapes are slightly smaller than a standard dreadnought, so it's not going to feel too bulky in your hands. And it comes with a great pickup system as well, so you can use these as a gigging guitar if you want to. If you are looking to spend that bit more, then it's definitely worth having a play on these. Compare it to the spruce version and see what you think you prefer tonally. I know I'm a big fan of walnut on an acoustic guitar. This is why I wanted to finish with this guitar. It's one of my favorite sort of more beginners aimed acoustics that came out in 2023, and it's no secret I'm a big fan of Taylor's. This guitar is really, really comfortable to play. So if you haven't had a chance to try one yet, I couldn't recommend it more. So that was my top acoustic guitars that are budget friendly, don't break the bank, but still sound fantastic from 2023. As I said at the beginning, not all of these are new releases this year, but they still remain in my top five, and I wanted to include a good variety of different models and tone woods so you can get a full scope of some of the amazing things that came out this year. Let us know in the comments section what you think of these guitars and what is your favorite acoustic guitar from 2023. I hope you've enjoyed this video. If you did, make sure to hit that like button and subscribe to the channel. Come find us over on socials too at Play Music Today. We're also on TikTok. Thank you so much for watching. I've been Meg. I will see you very soon.